Well, my understanding of this whole process, people's democracy, is that it is an inner party democratic process whereby you identify, you know, on the basis of meritocracy, you know, which are the most qualified people for the job and who are the most servant to the common good. And I think there is an empirical proof that this method is truthful, because China was able to lift 850 million people out of extreme poverty. And that is, you know, the greatest contribution to history I know of. But to lift so many people out of poverty and also to offer that to the developing country is exactly what is the crime in the view of the Western people who attack China on this point. Because China has overcome extreme poverty in its own country, and it is now helping developing countries to do likewise. This is exactly the same mindset which was the mindset of Malthus since the time of the British East India Company, which, as you know, was behind the opium wars against China. You know, it is not because of what they say. It is because the Chinese model has upset the whole world order, because you have offered for the first time to the developing countries the possibility to overcome poverty and underdevelopment. And they wanted to keep the colonial order. I think this is really the bottom line of the accusations against China. I've been in China many times, and my impression was always that, you know, the spirit of the people is extremely positive, optimistic for the future. And therefore, the CPC must be doing something very right. If you ask people in the West, most people are pessimistic about the future. So I think that expresses, in my view, more truthfulness than any of the propagandistic lines in the mainstream media. Democracy sounds very nice, but in many cases it is a label, and you had better look what is the content of the bottle on which the label is pasted. Because, you know, nowadays the different parties are mostly lobbying for different interests. And I would like you to read you another quote from George Washington, his farewell address as president of the United States in 1796, where he warned of the evil spirit of party in general. He says, the alternate domination of one faction over another, sharpened by the spirit of revenge, natural to party dissension, which in different ages and countries has perpetrated the most horrid enormities, is itself a frightful despotism. But this leads at length to a more formal and permanent despotism. And I think that is what we are seeing right now in the West, in many countries. Don't have real democracy, but you have a form of despotism, like in the United States. The polarization between the Republicans and the Democrats has torn the country completely apart. In Germany, where you have now the effort to form a new coalition, you know, the voter will not get as government what he or she voted for, because they form coalitions as they want. There were periods, however, where the Western democracy did function. This was the case in the beginning of the American Revolution, and it was the case with the Fifth Republic of Charles de Gaulle. But unfortunately, we in the West have moved very far away from these more noble conceptions. So we are more in the system of despotism, which George Washington warned about. Well, I think that there are indeed different models of democracy, according to the specific tradition and culture. It is very possible for these different systems to cooperate. However, this will only function if they are united by a higher one, must be the interest of all of mankind. I think the model, the closest to that, is what President Xi Jinping has proposed with the shared future, shared community. Because that includes this idea of humanity as a whole. So there is in the West an idea which is very similar, or actually identical, and that is the philosophical idea of a thinker from the 15th century, Nicolaus of Cus, the coincidence of opposites, which is the idea that since human beings are the only species capable of creative reason, that we always can think the higher one, a level of unity where all the differences disappear. So I think we need to enter a dialogue why this concept of the coincidence of opposites and President Xi Jinping's idea of the shared community of destiny are one and the same idea. And once we agree on that, I think a cooperation will be very easy.